Today we have two samples of milk. Now in this test we are going to find it out the water content in the milk. So this is the sample of pure milk and this is the sample of adulterated milk with the water content. So in our household, if suppose we have such a glass slide, then it's okay. Otherwise we can take any shiny surface like a steel or anything. Okay, so what is this test? We'll do a simply, we'll take a drop of a pure milk. Just put a drop of a pure milk over here and just slightly tilt the surface. If the drop stays over there, it is the pure milk. And if you more slightly tilt it, the trail of milk you can see. Okay, trail of milk is there. That is the indication of pure milk. And if there is adulterated milk with the water, adulterated means with water, not with any chemical, we can find it out that if we place a drop of water and lightly if we tilt, immediately drop, it drops down, okay, without any trail formation, without any milky slant. Okay, so you can see what is the difference in between pure milk and adulterated milk. This is the pure form of milk, and this milk contains other chemical adulteration, that is starch. In the market there are various type of milk products which has been prepared through different manufacturers. To make it more viscous, they add starch in it. So how to detect starch within our milk? So we have household, we have this cream for disinfectant or the povidine iodine solutions which we can generally found in our home every day. Okay, so we need to take a just pinch of this povidine iodine cream. Here in the test we need iodine, but we don't find pure iodine in our home, so we have taken a little bit amount of iodine and just put a few drop of iodine within the milk and drop of iodine within the pure form of milk. If you see, there is a color change within the adulterated milk and there is a no color change in the pure milk. Ghee, okay, from the market, and the pure ghee, there are very few pure ghee products are there in the market. Suppose this is the pure ghee which we have taken in one beaker and this is the adulterated ghee which looks very viscous in here. So we found that this is pure ghee because of its viscosity. Now we are going to check again once again with the iodine solution. Now what type of adulteration is there? The starch, generally these manufacturers add within the pure form of ghee to make it more viscous. So we'll take again a drop of iodine solution and we'll add in the adulterative form, and the drop in the pure form. So if we mix them together, we will found that there is a color change in the adulterated form of ghee and this is a pure ghee which don't have any color change. So we can identify based on iodine test the adulteration of starch in a ghee. Test, we are going to see the honey which we generally purchase from any retailer shop. There are two types of honeys. The one is very much pure honey which is very much viscous, and the other honey which is lightly viscous and adulterated with some sugar solutions also. So how to find out that the honey which we generally purchase, which is adulterated with the sugar solution? A very simple test. Here the adulterated honey is there and here the pure form of honey is there. 2 glasses of water, the half glass which is filled with the clear clean water, and we are just going to take a drop of honey. And put that drop of honey in the water. If you see, immediately the drop of honey will go at the bottom of water, a bottom of glass, and there is no mixture formed from the honey and water. So in the other way, if we take adulterated honey and if we put a drop of adulterated honey in the water, you'll see it will not directly go to the bottom, it will mix within the water, and that is the characteristic of adulterated honey. And there is a change in the adulterated and pure form of honey if we mix them in the water. So in this test we are going to see, generally we purchase fruits from the market like an apple, and to make more lustrous or more shiny, these sellers, they apply wax material on the fruit vegetables. Now we are going to check with a very simple test by using a simple knife which we generally use in our home. So just take a knife and use it on the vegetable. So just a little bit apply a knife and scrub the surface of fruit. If you scrub it, you will find that there is a nothing on the surface of fruit. The one which is having a wax material present on the fruit, we'll see that this is the wax material which is applied on the adulterated fruit. So with this simple test we can identify whether there is a waxy coating is there on the fruit or not. Thank you. Likewise, there is another vegetable, a lady finger, where these the sellers also apply a same type of food colors or malachite green color, which is harmful to the organism or human body, which is actually responsible to generate cancerous like a disease if we consume such a dyes. Again the same test. Take a swab of cotton, put it in the water, a little bit soaking in the water, and just rub it on the, and you will find there is a dye which is applied on the fruit vegetable. And in the second test, if it is not adulterated or the dye is not there on the leafy vegetable, then you will find that there is a no any color applied on the vegetable. So this is the simple test we can do when we purchase this vegetable. Thank you. In this test we are going to see the color adulteration to the green vegetables. Generally these green vegetables or leafy vegetables, they are green in color because of chlorophyll pigmentation. And so to make attractive the ventures or these vegetable in the market, the sellers actually apply a malachite green color on the food article. So to find out that malachite green color, it is very simple test. We generally have a cotton plug in our house. Just dip in the a little bit amount of water and then just wipe it from the green vegetable. We'll found that this is the adulterant color is applied on the vegetable. If you see on the non-adulterant, if you rub the cotton swab with the water from the on the vegetable, you will find that there is a no color applied on the vegetable. So these are two tests to find it out the dye for more green color applied on the vegetables. In this test, we are going to see the artificial food color or artificial synthetic color in the chili powder. So we generally purchase different types of chili powders in the market. So this is one chili powder which is coming from the market, and this is the rough chili powder which is we have made in our home. So to test whether there is adulteration or not, we need to take a little bit pinch of chili powder which is not red in color, if you see, and just put a drop of chili powder on the water, you will see that there is a little bit amount of chili powder goes down and the some of them are stays in the water but without forming any red color. So this is the original chili powder. If you see the adulterant chili powder, the pinch of chili powder, if we put it in the water, immediately there will be formation of red color. So this is the difference in between adulterated chili powder and non-adulterated chili powder. Thank you.